Oh, dancing. One of them things. You do it at ballroom, nightclubs. The one place you don't do it is on the FA Cup final. Check it out. Oh, viewers, can't believe it. That's exactly what I was doing when I saw the draw for the FA Cup in January. But sadly, it wasn't to be. Yes, this happened. I just can't believe it. I can't believe it. Not only did I get beat in the FA Cup third round, I actually lost against my sort of hometown club, if you want to look at it like that. I'm from Berkshire, Reading's a team in Berkshire, and quite frankly, I don't wish to talk about it anymore. Per our last game when we drew 1-1 here with Newcastle, if you remember. We've actually played a few games since. Not many green on there, quite a few red, four to be exact. So we had a home game to Sheffield United. We actually played quite well, went 1-1, and they scored in the 93rd of 95 minutes. I wasn't dancing then, put it that way. Then we went to Fulham and we got a result against Fulham. Fulham, we were flying high in the league. I think they were fifth when we took them on. Seemed to do all right. Wilfried Zaha with two goals there. So he's building up his tally. And then we had another, well, we had a home game to West Brom. This time, goalless, none of us can score as opposed to last time. Last time, as you can see there, we beat them 2-1. So this time it was 0-0. So it's still points, you know, the points are keeping us up. And then it came down to the game at Tottenham. Again, shouldn't have lost this game. We weren't a better side. All right, saying we're a better side, you know, nothing over a seven really, but we were a better side than what Spurs were on the day. Oh, Christ. Newcastle, home, lost 1-0. I think it was a goal in sort of the 88th minute, something like that. Wasn't a pretty sight. Dressing room was a mess afterwards. I wasn't happy. And then. Always not lost, viewers. Away to Everton, the big team that is Everton that was supposed to be, you know, starting off out of the blocks really fast and taking everyone to school. Didn't happen, viewers. Didn't happen. As you can see, we were victorious, 2-0 win. Wilfried Zaha and Eze with a goal. Now Eze, I sort of changed the way he played, put him out on the left as the inside forward, which is normally Wilfried Zaha's position. Guy's been playing out of his skin. He's had a few games where he's not been at it, but he's been at it most of the time. And then, of course, a great 3-0 thumping at home to Southampton. And then I thought, next game's going to be quite simple. Reading, FA Cup. Nope. As you can see, viewers, we're out. We lost on penalties. Lucky to be in the game, really. Reading, good side. Didn't think they would be. Underestimated them. Crucial schoolboy error. I will not do that again. I don't know if you remember me saying, viewers, earlier on in the series, I just can't do well in the cups. Cannot do well. So that's three in the last three games I've had in the cup. All of them have gone to penalties. Just can't finish the games off. Now I can finish my dinner, but I can't finish games. Moving on in today's episode, we will be playing West Ham and Burnley. Before we do that, I will show you the league table. There we go. So we're lying 11th, not too bad. 21 points from 16. A goal difference of 6 could be a minus, but it's not, so that's good. I think we should be all right. I mean, 14, you know, so we're 7 points clear of the drift. Oh, then we'll start again. We are 7 points adrift of the bottom three, which is certainly good for me. Expectations for us wasn't great, so happy with that. I mean, I'm just, viewers, I just need to get, this is just hard to take. Knocked out in the third round by Reading. knocked tight in the fourth round by Bournemouth. Little pattern there, viewers. Championship sides. So, viewers, here we go. English Premier League Division, West Ham versus Crystal Palace. There's the team. Gaeta at goal. Joel Ward right back. Favro, Sacco, centre-halves. Van Aanholt left back. Milivojevic, Gagliardini and Drinkwater my three midfielders. Townsend and Eze are my wingers with Michy Batshuayi up front. I'm not going to play Wilfred at the moment. He's a bit tired, so... Gary Cahill has now been registered. I've put him in the squad because I'm thinking of getting rid of Martin Kelly. He wants to leave, so if he doesn't want to be here, he can go. And I've just offered Gary Cahill a new contract. I think having experience around like him would be good. So my intention is him and Mamadou Sakho stay around unless a big offer comes in from Mamadou Sakho. We'll let him go. So we're favourites to be winning this. We should be winning. I'm not going to say that. Let's give the fans. I don't want to say the fans, but I think we're going to be left with not much. Let's tell them to keep the run going. Well, like a lead balloon, really, that, wasn't it? Okay. So, let's see what we're capable of doing against West Ham. Let's change that camera view. That's for my penalties. So, we will go on to TV. And we will... There we go. So, Masaku on the left side. Crosses cleared. Masaku again. Hala. Oh, they've scored. Oh, why? It's like a game of ping pong. 30, not even a minute played, 41 seconds. You know, they talk about catching you cold. Rebounds. So they're playing three centre midfielders. So we're on a balanced mentality. That's a great ball. Oh, great take from Michy. Where can he go? Townsend, inside right. Townsend shoots. Oh, he's just wide. Just wide from Townsend. Still, it's an improvement. It's an improvement. I'm gonna go a bit more positive against West Ham because they're sort of 19th position, so they're struggling to pick up points as it is. Maybe that's an opportunity where I'll be able to, as they say, get round the back. So catch me if no, don't sing John Barnes. Do not sing the John Barnes rap. It's in my head though. Right, well this is dog poo, isn't it? He says, right, it's a throw-in. Ward with a throw-in to Townsend. Back to Ward. Ward to Drinkwater. What can he do? Drinkwater. Back to Milivojevic. Milivojevic spreads it wide to Van Aanholt on a yellow card. Van Aanholt runs at the defence. Ah, poor shot. Oh, actually, another thing, I've brought Van Aanholt in, and since I've brought Van Aanholt back into the squad, we've actually down that left side really well. Riedewald's a very defensive player, defence-minded. Van Aanholt's a very attacking fullback, so that works sort of. Well, I'm not happy. I'm expecting to see. Right, I'm not angry, I'm disappointed. There we go. Right, 15, 20 minutes, nothing happens, we're going to make changes. 6-2, Vavro, we're not just nothing, just need a lift. Right, let's give them a shout, I'm going to demand. If that doesn't work, we're going to berate them. Okay, so I'm going to go up to attacking. I'm going to go to a little bit more direct because this doesn't seem to be working. I'm going to go more direct. I'm going to put more tempo on. And hopefully, fingers crossed, viewers, this is what we need. Right, okay, so that's not what. Danny Drinkwater, let's check this out. Danny Drinkwater, not doing well. He's only just come back, for goodness sake. So we'll put James McArthur on for Danny Drinkwater. We're gonna push forward. He's gonna be a box. We're gonna have two box to boxes and leave ourselves vulnerable at the back here. But you know, we've got to do something to get Wilfred on for Andros. He's not played well, and I'm gonna do it. That's why you're just not doing it for me. I had so many chances. You're just not scoring. So let's do this. 79 minutes gone. 1-0 down to West Ham in 19th position. It's just typical FM, this. Typical FM. Then I'll go and play United and win 3-0. You know, it's just... It's mind-boggling. Right, come on. Gaeta with the ball. I mean, I'd gladly take a draw right now. Favreau. Out to Ward on this right hand side. He plays it long towards Jordan Ayew. Excellent take. He's through here. He's running at the heart of poor ball. Gagliardini to miss Eze. Ayew scores. Just come on and he scored. It's 1-1. Get in, Jordan. Yes. Excellent piece of football. See, what did I say last episode, viewers? The magician. Maybe that should be my new name, the magician. It's a weak finish, to be fair. I mean, goal is just what he's already gone. Goal is already gone. He just can't adapt or reposition himself. So Yamaleko with a free kick, left foot. He's got a great left foot on him. Goes oof. Whew. Well, you know what? We've rescued that then. We've salvaged the draw out of that. Personally, I mean, we've got to be doing better in these positions. 0.59 on the GX, so, you know, just wasn't our night, was it? That's all we have to say.
So, viewers, here we are, match day for Burnley. Couple of changes I need to let you know about. So, in goal, Gaeta, left-back, Van Aanholt, two centre-halves, Sakho left-side, Favreau right-side, and Joel Ward playing on the right-back position. DM will be Luka Milivojevic, DLP Drinkwater Danny, and BBM will be Roberto Gagliardini. And making his change on the right hand side of the midfield of the attacking third will be Wilfred Zaha in place for Andros Townsend. On the left side, keeping his position is Eze, and up top, one more change. We've put George Nayu, the goal scorer of the last game, in. Batshuayi's back on the bench. And let's see if it brings us any joy whatsoever, because we need it. We need something. We do need something. So, as you can see, I won't go through the team sheet again, but I do reiterate and say it again. I think it's good the official team sheet this season looks good. So, here we go. Let's pump some fists. Let's get them pumped up for this game. It's going to be a dogged. But we will give... This never works with the fans. I never do the fans. It's... Right, so we know what we're in for. Bombardment, we know it's going to be. Unless Burnley have changed the way they play, but their results wouldn't suggest so. Here, they lie 19th. Oh, Brady. They lie 19th in the league table. Or maybe 20th now, actually. Brady with the corner. Swings out, an outswinging corner. Well defended by Luka Milivojevic. Chases down the ball. Brady. No one closing down. Westwood with a ball. Squares it to Rodriguez. Rodriguez back to goal. Plays it to Jack Cork in the centre. Jack Cork switches the ball to Brady on the left side. Oh, great tackle by Ward. And again, and again, and again. Excellent play by Joel Ward down Palace right-hand side. So the XG for Palace is nothing. Van Aanholt in swinging. Jordan Ayew. Oh, Sakho even. Right, we definitely need to, I think we need to go attacking. I need to demand more. This is, you know, we've got to be taking the game to them. So Ward with the throw-in to Drinkwater. Back to Ward. Ward crosses. Nick Pope gracefully accepts the ball. Plays it long. Milivojevic retrieves. Van Aanholt, left side, crosses. And again, Jordan Ayew. Oh, what a save by Nick Pope. And it's in by... Oh, I missed that, viewers. Completely missed it. Didn't even see what happened. I thought the goalie saved it and pushed it out. Well, Palace lead 1-0. Let's look at this again. So Van Aanholt goes to cross. Retrieves the ball. Right foot, crosses. Ayew. Oh, it's hit the crossbar and Zaha knocks... Do you know what? They all count, viewers. They all count. Doesn't matter how you score them. So that puts us back up to 10th position in the league, as you can see. So, you know, not bad. Good day's work so far, if we can just hold on. Clear-cut chances. Ooh, yeah, just reading. Okay. Yeah, I think I need to add something here on the right-hand side. But I don't know your, I don't know what yet, so I'm going to have a little toy around. I'm going to tell him to keep the performance up. Straight back into the game. As you do. Yeah, It was me, you Wally. It's my dog. Zaha with the ball. Gagliardini. Back to Danny Drinkwater on a yellow card. Gagliardini inside left to Van Aanholt. Van Aanholt, what can he do? He squares it. Nope. Comes back to Van Aanholt on his right foot. Wilfried Zaha again on the volley. It was nearly a kind of a replica of last time. It's my dog, Del Boy. Barks at the dog because he thinks someone's there when it's me putting my drink down. Stupid dog. So 70 minutes gone. How's our legs doing? Right, okay, we're going to have to... let's make some subs because they're all struggling here. Like Danny Drinkwater's really struggling. He can come on for James McArthur. Coyote can come on for Luka Milivojevic. And I think defensively, I'm tempted to get... Do you know what? I'm going to take Van Aanholt off and put Riedewald on and play defensively like that. So I'm going to go to cautious, confirm changes. 81 minutes gone. I'll tell you what we will do though. We will take the pace right down and we'll waste some time and we'll go very short passing. Hopefully this sees us over the line and we can get a victory. So 4 minutes of added time, 92 minutes almost played. It's looking like there it is. Another 3 points. Just say it was a good win. Nothing amazing. So that should carry us further off adrift from the bottom. So we're on 25 points in 11th. So we're 10 points from safety. Yeah, I'm just a bit worried about the next three games because that could drag us right back in, viewers. Right back in. Which I'm not happy about. I'll show you the schedule. It's not looking good, is it? Let's be realistic. So we've just had the Burnley game. We've got a Chelsea, Man City, Wolves, and then Liverpool twice in the Premier League.
I'm hoping you'll come back
and join me for what will be episode 5 of this FM21 save with me, Manager Marlo. I'm hoping you can subscribe, you can like, give me a thumbs up. Any comments you need to make, let's make them. We can deal with it together. And I'm hoping I can get more than 10 viewers.